Hey everybody, Chris from Pebble Creek. So episode 16, we got the brake mechanisms and all the driving gear, as well as the valve linkages. Everything's all installed now. That's ready to rock and roll. I think we're gonna have one more video. 17 will probably be the final video of actually building the locomotive. That'll be, we'll put on a set of water tanks, the last of the steps, and then that will be it for the locomotive. After that, I think we'll have one more wrap-up video where we have a lot of still photos going around it. We'll do up a set of tracks as a base, and then I got a case to put together for it as well, and then we'll do the final wire up, and that'll be it. And then of course after that we start the 1-300 Bismarck with the Pontos kit and scale decks, and it's going to be fully lit up as well. So all right, well, let's go take a look and see what got accomplished this time. And all right, thanks. All right, I'm just gonna bring the instructions over here to begin with. So this goes to the outboard hole. Where are my tweezers? Brainiac. Supposed to push that through first. And that goes there. All right. Well, that can't be right. There we go. Let's do this in reverse order this time. Get you in place. Okay. Ta-da! Now again. Let's see. Easier to do it backwards again. That one. Let's go there. Looks like she's on there.
All right. Okay. She should be in place. Now I'm giving it a little twist to separate it a bit there so that actually goes in. Okay. And that's that. Let's fix that there. Okay, I'm gonna rearrange things here. Alright, so I'm gonna put together this final driving mechanism here. Just a little bit. Okay. Now that that's in place, these sliders here. I'll just go in there like so. Now, these are the drive pistons. They actually go into the steam pistons. We're going to paint here back silver as well. We're going to paint the interior of this. We'll do like a dry brush brushing of silver as well. Now, I think we'll put that on there first. Okay, we'll just let those dry for now. Okay, so to get the same effect, let's paint the inboard side nice silver, and then what's left over, perfect. In my mind, that's I'm happy. All right. Okay. It's okay, we'll let that dry and we'll come back, set up, and we'll start putting some things on. Alright. Alright. So, this part here, it stays loose. And it's also going to slide loose here, so no glue. I am going to put a little touch of glue here because it's going to glue to here and here, and if everything goes correctly I'll still be a happy guy. Touch there, touch there. Okay, now I'm going to start by putting that in there. Okay, that's in place. Others. Can you see that? Oh yeah, you can see that part. Okay. Cruising there. Okay, I'm gonna file these down a little bit, do a refit. I'm just gonna file them, I'll be back. Okay, so I got this part all filed down now. Little bit of glue on her. Let's see if we can get her in there. Okay. Snip that part off. Connecting rods. This one. So that's gonna go in there. This is gonna come all the way back. Think so. Okay. My pin. Now. Which pin now? Well, we would have fought that for a long time. Okay, so let's take a knife here. And we'll just cut a little bit out. Make that hole just slightly bigger. So that pin actually fits. It fits. Oh, that's tight. It fits so nice on this side. It's not there, right? Okay. Let's cut a little bit more out. Try that again. Oh, okay, that fits much better. Okay. I think with confidence, we can now glue that to that. Yep, there's a little one steady. Okay. Let's put a, this little dollop. Whoa. A dollop. Okay. Okay. Not the way I want that to look. Lick some of that away. Okay, we'll come in and do touch-ups after on that. Okay, now on this part I'm actually going to use super glue. because normally these forks got a little pin on the inside to clip onto something like this, but this time it doesn't have the pin. And my concern is that I'm just not going to have the patience to hold it in place until the normal glue dries. Or you would do that 22 wrench here. Okay, we're going to pause for a second. Okay. I'm just gonna move down all that to a good spot. Okay. Now we're going to add this little pin here. So again, just a smidgen. Okay, now this part here I've had clipped on. This is pretty much the start of the model. It doesn't go there, but it kept it from being hurt. That's actually for the other side. Okay, so these hooks, I'm gonna go so this is gonna, these pins are gonna hook to here, and these hooks are gonna take on over to that. Oh boy. And there goes my keyboard. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to be honest. I think it's going to be easier for me to hook this part back up after this is actually on there, flipped over. Just a little bit of glue onto that thing there. Oops. Well, I was afraid of that happening. Well, let me need you fix here. Just pull that out for a second. Okay. Reinstall that. Okay. Well, that was stressful. Okay. Shooting. Got that pin back in place. Got more problems down the side here. Okay. Like I said, once we get this flipped over here, we'll install that. Alright. Let's see if we can figure this thing out. I bet you my fingers are in the way, aren't they? Alright. Hey, look at that, we did it, we did it. Cool. All right, we'll get the same done on the other side. All right. Let's see if we can get this final hookup done. Now I'm just gonna squeeze. Oh wow, that. Okay, that went a lot easier than the other side. All right. Okay, well, we'll get some pictures and gee, we're almost done. Next is we install some water tanks here on the sides. There's a few more steps to go around. Do some touch-ups everywhere, of course. Track and base in a case, and that'll be it. Okay, I'll get some pictures done, and we'll take a good close look at everything.